Pre-pubescent girls, dressed as the living goddess Kumari, sat in rows based on their allotted numbers to be worshipped, a ritual believed to ward off bad luck and disease. A total of 504 girls, all under 12, donned regalia resembling the goddess Kumari to perform rituals honoring Taleju Bhavani. This annual Kumari Puja, held by Newari girls in front of the Taleju Bhavani temple, venerates the goddess known as the earthly incarnation of divine feminine energy. The living goddess Kumari is regarded as a manifestation of goddess Durga in human form.
कुमारी पूजा चाहिँ यस्तो कि हाम्रो नानीहरूलाई चाहिँ राम्रो होस् भनेर हरेक वर्ष हुन्छ नै अब बच्चाहरूको एकदम दीर्घायुको लागि एकदम राम्रो होस् भन्नको लागि हो अब यो कुमारी पूजा गर्यो भने बच्चाले एकदम धेरै राम्रो हुन्छ बच्चाले एकदम स्वस्थ हुन्छ भनेर
कन्यास और गर्ल्स पार्टिसिपेटिङ इन दिस एनुअल प्रोसेसन आर टेकन टु द तलेजु भवानी टेम्पल वन अफ नेपालस शक्तिपीठ्स व्हिच ओपन्स ओन्ली फर अ डे ड्यूरिङ दशैं As part of the ritual, the girls are led around the temple of Taleju Bhavani, a Hindu deity whose face has remained hidden from the public for centuries.
उहाँहरु सधैँभरि कुमारी भन्न नसके तापनि आज एक दिनको लागि पनि कुमारी भनेर उहाँलाई पुकारोस् भनेर र उहाँहरु भित्र गर्दाखेरि उहाँहरुलाई कुनै पनि रोग व्याधि नहोस् भनेर चाहिँ हामीले कुमारी पूजा गरेका हुँ र यो कुमारी पूजा गर्नाले चाहिँ डोरो फाइदाछ
The procession of worshipping girls follow three methods, Hinduism, Buddhism and Tantrism. It's believed participating girls will be free from health problems. The rituals involve a Buddhist guru, a Tantric Karmacharya and a Brahmin. Nepal's unique tradition of worshipping the living goddess Kumari involves selecting a young Newar girl from the Shakya caste as the incarnation of goddess Taleju. Chosen after a strict process, the Kumari lives in isolation until she reaches puberty. Revered since the 17th century, the tradition began with the Malla kings and was continued by the Shah dynasty until 2008.